The next step in performing a manual cell count is to obtain a blood specimen. This is an EDTA blood specimen. You want to get a specimen that's no older than 12 hours from collection. Now, most laboratory procedures, you have to have it within 4 hours for testing, but for your practice, 12 hours will be fine. Then we're going to put it on the rocker. You need to rock it for about 5 to 10 minutes. You should rock it no longer than 15 minutes at one time. If you need to put it back on the rocker, that's fine, but no longer than 15 minutes at one time. Otherwise, the cells begin to break down and all your counts will be decreased. After you have completed mixing for 10 minutes, then you'll obtain your reservoir and prepare it for dilution of your specimen. You'll take out one reservoir. And you always want to put the lid securely back on the canister after you've taken one out. There's a little bit of moisture in here that keeps these from dehydrating, and this needs to be on tight. The first step of preparing these is to find the appropriate capillary. And on the canister, it will tell you the size of capillary tube that you need. This particular reservoir requires a 20 microliter capillary. Then you're going to puncture the diaphragm here, kind of ream it out a little bit. Just like that. Then you can take the guard off the capillary. Now we'll need to take the cap off the specimen. With a blood block, remove the cap from the specimen. And you can lay the cap on the counter here. Then holding the capillary tube, you can hold it between your middle finger and your thumb like this. Don't put your finger over the end yet. And then you'll tilt your blood specimen and watch it fill. You want to fill it all the way to the end of the capillary, just like that. Then with a moistened Kim Wipe, not sopping, just slightly moistened, wipe the blood off the outside of the capillary, just like this. Make sure you don't blot any out the tip this way, okay? So the sides just like this. Then don't tilt the tube down, keep the capillary horizontal, just like this, and bring up your reservoir and tilt your reservoir so that the tip of the capillary tube goes through the hole that you made, and then you can put it upright like this. Then you can put your finger over the end. When it's in this position, squeeze the reservoir, then seat it down in here like this, take your finger off, and then you're going to slurp it down. Okay, now you want to mix it good by inversion several times. And then you're going to rinse out the capillary tube by squeezing here several times. You can see the liquid rising up in the tube. You don't want it to go so far that it comes out the top, though. And then after that's rinsed out, then you want to mix again a minimum of 10 times, 10 inversions. Then we'll set the reservoir down. It needs to set for 10 minutes for adequate lysis.